So this is lesson 6.3, the unit circle. So you did the unit circle last year in grade 11 math. So we're basically gonna review it, look at it again, but we're gonna try and focus on radian measure instead of the degree measure like you were used to last year. Okay, so if you recall, this arrow pointing east is 0 degrees, and if we go a quarter of a circle, we get to 90 degrees. And a semicircle is 180 degrees, and another 90 is 270, and another 90 is 360, right? So we just go around counting by 90s. We can do the same thing counting by 45s, all right? So this here, and let me draw it a little bit more to the right. Okay, good enough. So this is 45 degrees, and essentially what this means is the angle from the origin, the angle that it makes with this standard arm here is 45 degrees. So that's what we're talking about there. So if we go around counting by 45, so another 45 is 90, another 45 is 135 degrees. Another 45 is 180, and then we get to 225. Keep adding, and we get 270, and then 270 plus 45 is 315. Okay, so let me just get rid of this. So we can also look at 30-degree angles. Now, 30 degrees is not quite halfway between 0 and 45. 30 is closer to 45 degrees, isn't it? In fact, if we chop this up into thirds, we could call these 15 degrees, so 15, 30, 45, and you could keep going. But the important thing to realize here is that 30 degrees is not halfway between 0 and 45. So when drawing the unit circle, let's make it closer to 45. Now, if I add another 30, I get 60, which will take me to here. Again, it's closer to the 45 degree angle than to the 90 angle. So add another 30 and I get 90. Another 30 is 120. Another 30 is 150. Another 30 is 180. And then 210, 240, 270. Okay, add another 30 and it gets us to 300. Another 30 is 330, and then takes us back to 360. Okay, and that's good for now. Now, let's try and replace these degree values with radian values. So I'm going to flick to a different color here. Now, we saw from last day that to change degrees into radians, you could just multiply by pi over 180 and then reduce. So you could multiply 30 by pi over 180 and then reduce, and you end up getting pi over 6. So that is correct. 30 degrees is pi over 6 radians. Let's start with 0. 0 degrees is 0 radians. They're the same. And then this is pi over 6 radians. And what we can do is kind of do the same thing that we did with degrees. We can spin all the way around the circle counting by pi over 6s. So this is 1 pi over 6. Another 30 degrees is 2 pi over 6. So this right here is 2 pi over 6, but that reduces to pi over 3, right? 2 pi over 6 is the same as pi over 3. Okay, add another pi over 6. Pi over 2. Okay, again, we're counting by pi over 6s, which is basically just 30 degrees each time. So 1 pi over 6, 2 pi over 6, 3 pi over 6, 4 pi over 6, which reduces to 2 pi over 3. 5 pi over 6, that does not reduce, so we just write it as it is. 6 pi over 6, that's pi, and we already know this. We know that 180 degrees is pi radians. Okay, add another, so that's 6 pi over 6, 7 pi over 6 is here. 8 pi over 6, remember we're counting by 30 degrees. Oops, wait a minute, that reduces to 4 pi over 3. Okay, so that's 8 pi over 6. 9 pi over 6 takes us to 6 o'clock here. So 9 pi over 6 reduces to 3 pi over 2. 10 pi over 6 is 5 pi over 3, 11 pi over 6, and then 12 pi over 6 reduces to 2 pi. All right, if that was confusing for you, you can kind of slow things down a bit and count by 90 degrees if you wanted to. So 0 radians, and then 90 degrees is equivalent to pi over 2 radians, right? If we just multiply by pi over 180, we can see that. And then we can just add another pi over 2. That takes us to a whole pi. And then add another pi over 2, and that's 3 pi over 2, right? 1 pi over 2, 2 pi over 2, 3 pi over 2, 4 pi over 2 reduces to 2 pi. But eventually, at some point, you're going to have to count by pi over 6s. Or you could just take the degree value and multiply by pi over 180, and then just reduce. All right, one more thing. Let's count by 45 degrees. Now, if we multiplied 45 by pi over 180, that is going to equal pi over 4 if you reduce, because 4 times 45 is exactly 180. So 45 degrees in radians is pi over 4. So let's go around. 1 pi over 4, 2 pi over 4, 3 pi over 4. Again, we're spinning around counting by 45 degrees. 4 pi over 4, we've got it. 5 pi over 4 is right here. 6 pi over 4, we've got it, 3 pi over 2. And then 7 pi over 4. And then 8 pi over 4, which is 2 pi. So there we go. Very quickly, we've got all the degree measures and their corresponding radian measures as well. Okay, the one thing that's left to do now is to state the coordinates for each point. So this is called a unit circle, meaning the radius is 1. So if that is true, then this point right here, that coordinate, will be the point 1, 0. That means due north, or 90 degrees, that is 0, 1, right? 0 in the x direction and 1 in the y direction. At 180 degrees, we have negative 1, 0. And 270 degrees, it's 0 in the x direction and then negative 1 in the y direction. Okay, so now we have to try and remember the other coordinates. So we know from our special triangles, or we should know, a little bit of a refresher here. One of the special triangles is 45, 45, and then the side lengths are 1, 1, root 2. So we know that the sine of 45 degrees is 1 over root 2. And if you remember from last year, the sine of these angles corresponds to the y value of this point on the unit circle. So this value right here is 1 over root 2. And then it turns out that also the cos of 45 is 1 over root 2 as well. And the second value, or the x value of these coordinates, represents the cos of that angle. So this is also 1 over root 2 here. So likewise, if we skip across to the other quadrant, this is going to be negative 1 over root 2 and positive 1 over root 2, right? Because it's a negative x. This is the origin, 0, 0. So it's a negative x value and then a positive y value. And then down here, they're both negative. So in this quadrant here, both the cos and the sine are both negative. And then we flip across over to here, and we get positive 1 over root 2 and negative 1 over root 2. So in this quadrant, the coses are positive and the sines are negative. Okay, so the 30 degrees, the cos of 30, again, just reviewing your triangles here. If this is 30 and this is 60, then that makes this 2. This is 1 and this is root 3. Okay, so the cos of 30 is adjacent over hypotenuse, so root 3 over 2. So this value here is root 3 over 2, and the y value is 1/2. And we can kind of see that. We can kind of see that the height of this, like if we were to draw an imaginary right angle triangle here, the height of this is 1/2. It's exactly halfway up to 1, right? Like this has a distance of 1, and this looks like it's 1/2. So the y value, or the sine value of 30 degrees, is 1/2. And then the cosine of 30 is root 3 over 2. Now, at 60 degrees, it's easy. It's just reversed. So the cos is 1/2. Oops. The cosine is 1/2, and the sine is root 3 over 2. So again, just remember that this first value here represents the cos of 60 degrees, and this is the sine of 60 degrees. And this one here is the cos of 45 and the sine of 45, and that's the same all the way around the circle. So the sine of 90 degrees is 1, because that's the second coordinate here. Okay, so we can flip these things across. If we take this point and flip it over here, we get negative 1/2 positive root 3 over 2. And this point at 150 degrees is negative root 3 over 2 positive 1/2. And if we flip down here, we get negative root 3 over 2 negative 1/2. And we flip across to this side and we get root 3 over 2 negative 1/2. And what am I missing here? This point down here at 240 is just the reflection of this one up here. So it's negative 1/2 negative root 3 over 2. And then we flip around to this one and we get positive 1/2 negative root 3 over 2. Okay, so there's a lot of stuff there. It's really the same unit circle that you did last year, but we've included all the radian measures of our special angles all the way around. Okay, so if we look at the next page, we're going to use the unit circle to determine the exact values of the six trig ratios for each angle. Okay, I'm going to skip 315 and 2 pi over 3. Let's go to 19 pi over 6. So the sine of 19 pi over 6, yikes, 19 pi over 6 does not appear anywhere on your unit circle. You see that this is 1 pi over 6, 2 pi over 6, 3 pi over 6, and we go all the way around, and we get to 11 pi over 6. So I need to get to 19 pi over 6. I could keep counting pi over 6s, 12 pi over 6, 13 pi over 6, 14, 15 pi over 6, and I could keep going, or we could do a little manipulation here and say that that this is really the same as the sine of 7 pi over 6. And the reason why is because 19 pi over 6 is equal to 2 pi, so one full revolution, plus another 7 pi over 6. Wow, how did we get that? Well, this is 12 pi over 6, right? 2 pi is just the same as 12 pi over 6. And we want to get to 19 pi over 6. So if you just add another 7 pi over 6, we'll get that. So 19 pi over 6 is really just all the way around the circle plus another 7 pi over 6. So therefore, we're really looking for the sine of 7 pi over 6. And if you flip around to the unit circle, 7 pi over 6 is right here, and the sine is negative 1/2. So we can just fill that in here, negative 1/2. Okay, the cos of 19 pi over 6 is really equal to the cos of 7 pi over 6. And that is equal to negative root 3 over 2. Again, if you look at your unit circle. Okay, so I'll let you do the tan, and then we need the other three ratios, cosecant, secant, and cotangent as well. Let's just quickly do 2a. So the cotangent of pi over 4, cotangent, remember, is cos over sine. So we really have to do the cos of pi over 4 divided by the sine of pi over 4 over the cos of pi over 3 times the cosecant of pi over 2. And cosecant is 1 over sine. So we're multiplying by 1 over the sine of pi over 2. And now we just use our unit circle. The cos of pi over 4 is 1 over root 2. The sine of pi over 4 is 1 over root 2. And we're going to divide by 1/2 times 1. And 1 over root 2 divided by 1 over root 2 is the same value. So that's just 1 on the top. And then we have 1/2 times 1, which is 1/2. And 1 over 1/2 is equal to 2. So the answer there is 2. Okay, I'll let you finish up with part B. And we'll talk about this lesson a little bit more in class. Okay, bye for now.